Hello everyone. Now we are going to discuss about the RMS and average value of periodical and alternating signals. Okay, so as in our previous lecture we have discussed how to get the RMS value and what is the empirical formula should be for average value. Okay, now this is a alternating wave. Okay, now suppose this function is equal to Im sin omega t, Im sin theta. Suppose this is theta. I am considering it as omega t or theta. So this is my I. Im sin theta. Understood? This is 0, this is pi, and this is 2 pi. So what is the time period? We know this wave shape will again repeated. It will be again repeated, so the time period will be 2 pi. Okay, so as per our RMS, what is the formula? Formula of I RMS. So as it is I have to get I RMS. So what is I RMS? I RMS will be the equation of the signal. So this will be I, this was small I, so I have to write it as small I. Now what is I square, and I have to integrate this I square with respect to theta. So what will be the time period? The time period is 0 to 2 pi. So it will be 0 to 2 pi. Okay. Now what we have to do? Root mean square. So this is the squared part we got. So we are getting the I, we make them squared, and we got the total integration of the, that means the area under between 0 to 2 pi we take. Now we have to get the mean, that means the average. So the average will be this, and we have to take the root of it. So this will be the formula. Okay, so if I want to get the RMS value of this sinusoidal signal, how we will calculate? So I have to write that this is 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi. What I have to write instead of I, what is the signal, mathematical expression of this signal? It will be Im sin omega, sin theta. So Im square sin square theta d theta. Understood? So now Im square is a constant, so I can take it outward. Now this is sin square theta. We know that the sin square theta should have a formula that if I take 2 sin square theta here, then I can convert it into 1 minus cos 2 theta in this form, right? So I am writing it directly in this way. Suppose this is my expression, I am taking it as 4 pi, understood? So Im square as a constant, I am taking it out of the integration. So I am integrating it to sin square theta, that is 1 minus cos 2 theta d theta. Okay, so this is the step. And then what we have to do? We have to integrate this d theta and cos 2 theta. So what will we get? 1 minute. So if I integrate, what I am going to get? I am going to get Im square by 4 pi. So this is Im square upon 4 pi. Okay. After this integration, this will be theta, and cos 2 theta will be sin 2 theta divided by 2. So it will be sin 2 theta divided by 2. And the limits will be 0 to 2 pi, and it will be under this root. Now if you put the value here, you will get here 2 pi, And you know sine 2 pi means nothing but 0. So sine 0 is also 0, sine 2 pi is also 0. So you will get, you will put here, you will finally get the expression like this will be, if you put 2 pi here, it will become 0. So we are taking 2 pi only here and we are getting Im square by 4 pi into 2 pi. So Im square by 4 pi into 2 pi under root. So what we are getting? This is 2. So we are getting, it is basically Im by root 2. So the RMS value of this sinusoidal signal will be Im by root 2. That we know, we have proved it by the mathematical expressions. Okay. Now let us discuss about the average value. First, let me clear all these things. So now we are going to get the average value of this sinusoidal signal. Understood? So how we will get the average value? Now the average value, we know if I take the average value from 0 to 2 pi, this will be cancelled out because the average of this part and the average of this part is going to nullify each other because they are having opposite direction. Magnitude negative ones, opposite magnitude. So what we are going to consider? We will only consider what is the average value of this part only. Okay, so we are going to consider the average value of this part only so that we can at least understand what is the average value. It will be same but equal. So we are going to consider only the average value for 0 to pi. So I average, we are going to calculate I average. So what it will be, the formula will be the I, this will be the I. Okay, we have to integrate it between 0 to pi. Understood? Because if we take 2 pi, it will be 0 again. Now, so we are going to get the average for the only this portion. So 0 to pi. And we are putting t theta here. So now average. So as it is average, what we have to do? What we have to do? We have to take the average means the time duration what we have take. We have to divide it with that time duration, that is pi. We are dividing it with pi. So if I put the equation, that is Im sin theta, so it will be 1 by pi integration of 0 to pi Im sin theta d theta. So if I integrate this, I have to take Im out of the integration sign as it is a constant. So I am getting only the sine theta part is remaining. So sine theta, integration of sine theta becomes minus cos theta. So it will be minus cos theta and it will be pi to 0 to pi. So I am getting Im by pi. What is cos pi? Cos pi equal to minus 1. So it will be minus minus plus 1. And cos 0 equal to, so it will be cos pi minus 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 plus 1 minus here minus 1. So we are getting, this is basically 2. So 2 Im by pi. So this is the average value of this part. Okay, the if you take this part only, you will take the average value as 2 Im by pi. Okay, so 2 Im by pi is the average value of this sinusoidal signal for this part. Understood? Thank you.